A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 1st August, on the front page you have regarding CCD founder Siddhartha. He was cremated in family estate. Then this is Supreme Court takes note of complaint by rape survivor's family. So this is letter to Chief Justice of India which has surfaced after the accident. So this is regarding the Unnao rape survivor case, the letter written by the family on July 12 to Chief Justice of India on the threats received from the accused persons has been taken suo motu cognizance of, and the Supreme Court is now going to look into the matter. So a truck collided with her car, causing serious injuries to her and her lawyer. So BJP MLA from Uttar Pradesh is accused in the rape case, and he was arrested in last April too. This is one singer, the BJP MLA. Then below you have officials keep vigil as Godavari rises at Bhadrachalam. So this is regarding Telangana here. Godavari water levels have touched 50 feet in Rajahmundry in Telangana. So this is a cause of concern now. It's just 4 feet below the first flood warning level. Then on page 7 you have heavy rains in western Maharashtra fill up dams, boost water stocks. So this is regarding the heavy rains in the last 72 hours, how water levels have increased. 4 major dams in Pune are filled up to 75% of the storage capacity. Even in Vidarbha region, the deficit is down to 19% from 29%. So this is there. But Marathwada region continues to be problematic with rainfall deficit figure down to 27% from 30%. So even the Godavari river, which is feared to be on danger level, flood fear level, that is also linked because Godavari flows from Maharashtra down into Telangana, Karnataka, Telangana. So here you can see this is the flood levels here. And below you have Goa planning to reserve 80% jobs in factories for locals. So labor employment policies will be drafted in 6 months' time, says the Goa chief minister. So it will reserve 80% jobs for locals. We have earlier seen how Andhra Pradesh government also has come up with such a law, AP employment of local candidates. It mandates at least 75% state candidates in jobs. Locals should be in given preference in jobs. So that is 74% reservation, and Goa plans for 80% reservation. Then on page 9 you have 2,461 students dropped out of IITs in the last 2 years. So this is what the Ministry of Human Resource Development stated in Rajya Sabha. It says out of these dropouts, from total dropouts of 2,461 from 23 IITs, about 57% were from IIT Delhi and IIT Kharagpur. So this is shown here, you can see, and it said that 47.5% of these dropouts are from scheduled castes, scheduled tribes and OBCs. So of course they constitute around 50% of reservations, so near 50% of dropouts are them. So that is nothing great about it. It is commensurate with the percentage of reservation which we have. So this dropout in IIT courses is said because of wrong choices, failed, poor academic performance or personal and medical reasons. So here you can see the reservation percentage. SCs have 15% reservation, STs 7.5% and OBCs 27%. Total is 49.5%. So that is the percentage of reservation, and this is the percentage of dropout, 47.5%. Then below you have 10% quota case for statute bench. So 3-judge Supreme Court bench has reserved orders on the 10% quota for economically weaker section in government jobs and educational institutions. So you can see this will be referred to the constitutional bench now. So this will be looked into. The 3-judge bench is going to respond to this question of referring these petitions to a constitutional bench. So, this 103rd Constitutional Amendment Act 2019 had been passed, which provides for 10% reservation in for economically backward classes in government jobs in education. So that is being challenged. There are a number of petitions filed. And you should know that there is already Indira Sohani case of 1992, the judgment which had barred reservation solely on economic criteria. And it had also placed a 50% cap on reservation. So both these are violated by, both these provisions of Indira Sohani case by the 103rd Constitutional Amendment Act. Then this is cabinet approval for revised chit fund bill. So the previous bill had lapsed and now this chit fund amendment, this bill 2019 has been approved by the Union Cabinet and will be introduced in the Parliament. So this bill is to reduce the compliance burden of registered chit funds in the country and protect the interests of subscribers. So we have already seen there is one unregulated deposit scheme, Panzai schemes bill, which is being passed by both the houses, and now this is a chit fund bill. On the editorial page, the first editorial is Beyond Talaq. So this says India needs a non-sectarian, gender-neutral law that addresses desertion of spouses. So both houses have passed the triple talaq bill, but this editorial says that it should not be sectarian for a particular religion. It should not be for particular gender, like only for women, but it should be a general law on addressing desertion of spouses if the spouse leaves. If one of the spouse in couple, one of them leaves the other. So what should be the further development in that case? There should be a law on that matter, because desertion is also quite common in marriages. Then this is logged out. So this says Brazil must recognize that the Amazon rainforest is a universal treasure. So it's a matter of global concern that deforestation is taking place in Amazon forest in Brazil, and it is increasing rapidly since the new government has taken over in January 2019. Satellite images show that 4,200 square kilometer forests have been destroyed from Jan to July under the new government. So this is a global concern. The rainforests are a universal treasure is being spoken of here. The lead article, in hate crime fights, a voice still feeble. So this is regarding the Indian Parliament, how it needs to recognize hate killings as an act of terror. So US has recognized it. So US Senate 100 years ago, you can see it took 100 years to approve a bill to make lynching a federal crime. So now India also needs to take a cue from it and has to call hate crimes as an act of terror and pass a law on lynching. So this is US government's Victims of Lynching Act of 2018. So India also needs such a law is spoken of here. And this is fortifying the Africa outreach. So this is regarding President Ramnath Kovind. He commences 7-day state visit to African nations. So this is being spoken of. There is disconnect between India's developmental assistance to an economic engagement with Africa. So we provide developmental assistance to them, but economic engagement is not of the same scale. So we need to improve our ties with Africa. So India has substantive economic engagement, but there is a conspicuous disconnect, it is said, between the developmental assistance and economic engagement. So here there are some points written of how we can be more economically productive in Africa. So first it says we need to take direct control of our development program instead of handing out funds to intermediaries such as African Union, African Development Bank, etc. It says India's developmental assistance should prefer countries with its substantive interests. So that developmental assistance should be provided to such countries which are India's top trading partners. And thirdly, it says we should prefer aiding countries which are willing to help us. So like countries, we should give aid to those countries which provide access to their natural resources to using our generics. So, and then it says fourthly, the aided project selected should be compatible with local requirements. So they should be cost effective, scalable, future ready and commercially replicable. And it says for greater transparency, India should prefer its public sector to implement the aid projects in Africa. And sixthly, it says Indian head of mission in the recipient African state must be an integral part of the aid stream, including project selection, coordination and implementation. it says, and finally it says what it has missed out in the entire article, that this should not distract us from the duty to provide the needed humanitarian assistance to Africa. So we should provide assistance to Africa, but we should link aid with our own economic benefit is what this article is trying to say, which has not been India's policy. Then this is the perils of being a woman and a Muslim. This is regarding Sri Lanka, that how in Sri Lanka after the Easter Sunday attacks, the country's Muslims face constant scrutiny and, you know, reactionary forces are turning their violent gaze on them. So violence against Muslims are being seen. And this is transforming livelihoods through farm ponds. So this is regarding how farm ponds can be an effective tool for rainwater harvesting. And this is cauldron of sexual misconduct. It is said so often do Indians encounter the horrific act in their consciousness that it has escaped their conscience. So regarding sexual harassment. On page 12 you have plan for single water disputes tribunal. So the Lok Sabha has passed the bill that promises faster redress of water disputes between states by putting in place a new architecture for tribunals that handle interstate water disputes. So this is Interstate River Water Disputes Amendment Bill 2019. So this has been introduced in the Lok Sabha. And this is Lok Sabha clears bill to evict illegal occupants. So this is Public Premises Eviction of Unauthorized Occupants Amendment Bill 2019, which has been passed by the Lok Sabha. So the Act of 1971 has been amended through it, which provides for eviction of unauthorized occupants. Then below you have Motor Vehicles Bill won't usurp rights of states. So this is what Union Transport Minister Nitin Gadkari asserted in Rajya Sabha. It says that and Rajya Sabha has cleared the bill. So it has called for increased penalties too. So that is one aspect of the bill, and it seeks to improve road safety through multitude increases in penalties for traffic violations. That is one aspect, and it also aims to streamline the licensing and road permit process. So that is said to be against the federal feature as such. So that is a concern, but then the government says will not usurp the rights of the states. And then this is Thailand in talks with India to buy BrahMos cruise missile. So this is BrahMos supersonic cruise missile, which India and Russia have jointly developed. And now Thailand is in talks with India for its purchase. Also, other countries have shown interest in BrahMos. But this is the first case where the negotiations have fructified. Means they are becoming fruitful. On international page, you have US-China to hold further talks after constructive meeting. So this is regarding US and Chinese negotiators. They agree to meet again in US in September after holding frank and constructive talks in Shanghai. So the trade talks have now been continued again. They were suspended for some time. So this is a further development. And this is US Federal Reserve, means US Central Bank, like RBI of India, USA as Federal Reserve. So US Fed cuts interest rate for first time since 2008. So this is a rate cut which is seen now, a rate cut by 25 basis points. So it is now 2 to 2.25%, the federal funds rate. So if this is reduced, means credit is easily available in the market. So that's how it gets translated, the key interest rate, the way it happens in India too. So this is said to be the first time since 2008 recession that a move to stimulate the economy has taken place, and it has been due to sustained pressure from President Donald Trump. So governments always want rate cuts to be reduced so that there's a boost in the economy and more money easily available in the economy does well. But Federal Reserve also has, or all central banks have a cause of concern that that inflation should not go beyond control. So money should be easily available at lower interest rates, but it should not cause inflation. Otherwise, it would be detrimental to the economy in the long term. On business page, you have Air India divestment may see global participation. So this is regarding Air India, the second attempt at disinvestment is taking place, and it is now likely to include even global participation. Earlier that was not allowed. You can see the Air India should comply with the norm of cap of foreign direct investment into the national carrier at 49%. So now international entities seeking to form joint ventures with Indian companies would take place. Then this is core sector growth slows to 0.2% in June. So the 8 core industries growth dropped to 0.2% in June. So these are 8 core sectors under IIP, Index of Industrial Production. So this is said to be a drop mainly due to contraction in oil related sectors as well as in cement production. So the 8 core sectors indicate how the economy is moving as such, too, because these are core industries which further get reflected in other industries as such. So the 8 core sectors are also listed down here, you can see. Coal, crude oil, natural gas, refinery products, fertilizers, steel, cement and electricity. Then on page 16 you have SEBI mulls weather freight derivatives. So SEBI is actively examining the feasibility of allowing derivatives contracts based on intangibles such as weather or freight in the Indian commodity segment. Also it is looking at introducing exchange traded funds on metals, on better designed options contracts and also ways to increase participation of hedgers and encourage delivery based settlements. So these are some of the reforms under consideration by SEBI. So it has formed 5 working groups, each looking at an issue related to commodities segment. Then on the last page here you have Indonesian villagers resist relocation plan from Komodo. So this is Komodo dragon. There are thousands of residents of an island in eastern Indonesia that are resisting a government plan to relocate them and close the island next year in a bid to conserve this rare Komodo dragon. So this is in news here, you can see. So closing the island is a risk to homes and livelihoods is what has been stated. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website asr.com. And sorry for the delay in uploading the current affairs and PDFs, but that would be done as a personal emergency and crisis situation is being faced by me. Thank you.